Blackstone Publishing presents Human Work in the Age of Smart Machines by Jamie Merisotis. This book is read by Malcolm Hillgartner. For my parents, Peter and Diana Merisotis, who taught me that the most important part of work is not what you earn, but what you achieve. Prologue. Work is a good thing for man, a good thing for his humanity, because through work, man not only transforms nature, adapting it to his own needs, but he also achieves fulfillment as a human being, and indeed, in a sense, becomes more a human being. Pope John Paul II, Laborum Exercens, On Human Work, 1981. An old saying about music goes, writing about music is like dancing about architecture. I've felt this way a lot over the years as I've tried to write about the world of work and how we prepare people for work through learning. Much like dancing about architecture, I wonder if writing about something as complex and nuanced as work is an almost absurd exercise. After all, billions of people around the world work, and they do so in as many ways as musicians make music. But I continue to write about work and the development of human talent necessary to accomplish this work for a fundamental reason. Work matters. People work not only because it helps them economically, but also because it offers them social mobility, personal satisfaction, and a range of other rewards that are almost impossible to describe. The technology innovator and investor Roy Bahat may have summed it up best when he said, most people work not only for stability, to make money, to have a comfortable life, but for dignity. You're part of something greater than yourself, and it connects to some broader whole. The existential threats the world faces, pandemics, global warming, and challenges to free societies, serve to remind us of our shared humanity, our desire to build and maintain relationships, and the importance of work in our lives. The emergence of COVID-19 as a public health nightmare showcased the perseverance of people who are prepared for work in an uncertain future, as it underscored the need to develop coordinated approaches for readying everyone. Work is changing in unprecedented ways as technology and artificial intelligence take over more of the tasks people used to do. The robots might or might not be coming to take our jobs, but it's clear that society is being thrust into a new era of human work, the work only humans can do in the age of smart machines. Human workers will do more than make money to support themselves throughout the rest of their lives. They will be learning, earning, and serving during the course of their lifetimes, participating in a virtuous cycle that expands human potential and allows all of us to make a difference. We'll need to prepare for this new era by developing our human capacities such as compassion, critical thinking, ethics, and interpersonal communication in college, at work, and in our daily lives. This means we need new approaches to formal and informal learning after high school that intentionally develop human traits, while also expanding opportunities for service so people can gain greater meaning and satisfaction from life. In my 2015 book, America Needs Talent, I suggested the acquisition and development of talent will drive America's future prosperity. By talent, I mean not simply innate ability, such as being able to play a sonata or score a penalty kick, but more broadly, the combination of knowledge, skills, abilities, and other capacities that are honed through learning and experience in ways that not only improve individuals, but advance society in general. Evidence from the past few years shows this talent imperative exists globally. Data from the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, and individual countries show demand for talent developed through formal learning has increased more rapidly than expected. The future of work in a technology-mediated world will create even greater demands for this more fully developed talent. This book, however, is not titled The World Needs Talent, or America.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.